How does your product use or challenge conventions, and how does it represent social groups or issues?
While picking our genre that we wanted to do for our film, me and Kayla both had very different views of what we wanted our film to be like. Kayla wanted a more mysterious serial killer horror movie, and I wanted more of like a fun teenage high school drama, I guess. And so we landed on the introduction being really like fun, flowy, showing who the characters are, what they do, what their hobbies are. And then we get to Cameron getting hit with a bat. And that's when we find out that it's not a fun, just high schoolers living their life film. And it's now a horror film, in addition to it being a fun high school film. Our serial killer is an outsider looking into a small, close friend group who does everything together, knows everything about each other, and our serial killer wants to be like them and with them. And so the reason he starts killing off the friend group is because he wants what they have, and if he can't have it, then they shouldn't either. In our film, we wanted to have a mysterious feel and a mysterious tone and mood, and so we didn't go with the general demographic of a kind of like mid-40s serial killer. So we chose to have a high school student who was part of a small friend group who is kind of stupid and they don't know much. So we had a teenager be our serial killer. We did have the serial killer be a male, which is the general description of a serial killer. We just took the age and changed it. This changed the social group because it's not what you generally know, and it made serial killers relate to high schoolers. And our high school students were pretty normal kids who just were living life, going through school, and then they hit a roadblock in life, which happens to everyone, and they died.